Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, students. I hope everything is fine with all of you. Today we will discuss about the family Mimosaceae. The family Mimosaceae is commonly called the Acacia family. So now come to discuss family Mimosaceae in our course BOT 312 Plant Systematics and Development. Now come to discuss the distribution pattern of the family Mimosaceae. The family Mimosaceae or the Acacia family are mostly tropical and subtropical tropical in distribution. So they have mostly tropical and subtropical trees and shrub comprising about 40 genera and 2000 species. Classification of the family Mimosaceae. It is placed in the kingdom Plantae, division Angiospermae, class Dicotyledoneae, order Rosales, and family Leguminaceae, while the subfamily is Mimosaceae. Now come to discuss the morphological characters of the family Mimosaceae, starting with the vegetative characters. Habit wise, they can be herbs like in Mimosaceae. They can be clumber like in Entarda. They can be a medium sized spiny tree like Prosopis and Albizia. And hydrophytes like Nepenthea oleracea. Many members are xerophytic like Acacia and the Prosopis. Leaves are caulin and ramel. Caulin leaves, when the leaves are found on nodes of the stem, then they are called caulin leaves. And ramel leaves, when leaves are found on branches, then they are called ramel leaves. The leaves are alternately arranged on the stem, and they can be pinnate or bipinnate compound leaves. They are stipulate, having stipules, and stipules sometimes modified into spines, like in Acacia, Nilotica. In some species of Acacia, the petiole becomes flattened into a phyllode and leaflets fall down. Leaflets show movement, like in Mimosaceae and Nepenthea. Mimosaceae and Nepenthea usually shows the slipping movements. Come to discuss the floral characters of the family. They have usually spike or racemose inflorescence, like in Prosopis. Also, they can have cymose head, like in Acacia nilotica. And in Acacia nilotica, they show head like globule inflorescence. So the head like cushion like inflorescence is found in Acacia nilotica, which is very common plant in our country. Flowers of the family Mimosaceae. All the flowers are pedicellate or subsessile, like in Acacia or sessile, Prosopis, bracteate, actinomorphic. Hermaphrodite means they are bisexual. Hypogynous means the flowers have ovary superior. Complete flowers having both the androecium and gynoecium in the same flower. Tetra or pentamerous. Sometimes the scalex and petals are 4 in number, or sometimes they are 5 in number. So they can be tetra or pentamerous, and the flowers are very small. Calyx consists of 5 sepals, which are gamosepals, that is united or fused sepals, valvate or imbricate, green or petaloid are usually in Acacia analytica and their inferior in position. While corolla consists of 5 petals, polypetalous or gamopetalous, both condition is present, like in Acacia and Albizia. The estivation of the petals are valvate and the petals are inferior in position. Induration consists of 4 free stamens in Mimosa. Mimosa or 10 free stamens in Prosopis, indefinite or and monodelphous condition in Albizia. Filaments usually long, anthers are dithecous, that is the 2-celled anthers, and the pollen grains often in packets and often gland dotted to attract the insects. Gynoecium having 1 carpels, 1 locus, and marginal placentations, or one or many ovules are present in a carpel. Style is long and filiform, while stigma is minute and simple. They have superior ovary, that is the flower is hypogynous and the placentation is marginal, means the ovules are attached with the margin of the ovary, like in this diagram. So the characteristics of gynoecium usually similar to the Cecilpiniaceae and Pipliniaceae family, because all of these 3 families are placed in family Leguminaceae. They also has legume or lamentum fruit. Now come to discuss the flower formula and the flower diagram of the family Mimosaceae. Flowers are usually bracteate. Bracts means the extra whorl present outside of the calyx. Flowers are actinomorphic, that is the when the flowers are cut down from any angle of the it is equally divided. Flowers are bisexual or hermaphrodite, it is presence of both the sex organs in a same flower. Calyx are usually 4 or 5, means they can be tetramerous or they can be pentamerous, but the sepals are united or fused, the chemic sepalous condition, which are represented in flower diagram just like this. The corolla are tetramerous or pentamerous, both. They can be gamo or polypetalous. Androecians consist of 10 stamens or infinite as well. Sometimes they are present in different valves, and the gynoecium is superior and having 1 carpel, and the placentation is marginal. Now come to discuss the economic importance of the family. The family members are used for timber yielding, ornamental purposes, fooder, so for soap manufacturing, for medicinal use, and for gums and dyes. As food, Acacia catechu, known as katha, is obtained from Acacia catechu. Gum arabic is obtained from the barks of Acacia analytica, that is the Acacia arabica. and Acacia Senegal obtained a type of gum, and a type of gum is also obtained from Albizia Lebec. The flowers of the Acacia decurrens yield a perfume, and the bark of the acacia yields tannin, which is used in leather tanning. Adentra wood is used to yield a red dye. Prosopis is grown as a hedge plant and also as a windbreaker in Rajasthan to check spreading desert, acts as water indicator. Durable timber is obtained from the acacia, melon xylem, lysistoma, and from xylia. Xylia is also commonly called the ironwood. So, students, at the end of this lecture, here I want to mention a list of common plants belonging to the family Mimosaceae, which have acacia, Albizia Lebec, Mimosa, Nepenthea, Prosopis, and Xylia. And at the end of the lecture, I again want to repeat identification feature of the family. The identifying morphological features of the family are leaves are net range, usually alternate, flowers are tetra to pentamerous, petals are separated, flowers regular or irregular, usually regular flowers. Petals distinct or united at the base, and the woody or herbaceous with alternate stipulate compound leaves, and the flowers are hypogynous and sometimes they are perigynous as well. The ovary position is usually superior, and the fruit usually lumentum. The flower arrange in dense heads or spike, and the flowers are small, regular, and the 4 to 5 mirrors. So, students, thank you so much for being with me. I hope we will meet in our next lecture. Allah Hafiz.